Good day, class. Here we're discussing ECN 303. We'll be looking at national income. We began last week. Last week we looked at a meaning, we looked at the concept of national income, then we also look at methods in measuring national income. Under the method, we looked at the expenditure, the output method, and the income method. So they'll be looking at uses of national income problem. The circular flow, then also look at national income and economic structure. Now, uses of national income. Now, as economists, first, national income helps us to look at the sectorial contributions in the economy. Whether the sector is performing through the national income, because national income, we said that is the records of all economic activity within economic year or accounting year. For example, if you're looking at to look at various sectors like agricultural sector, education sector, through the national income account, we'll be able to know which of the sector is performing, doing well, or which of the sector is underperforming. Also, it helps us to look at the production structure in the economy. Not just the production structure, it helps us to look at the level and the structure of consumption, savings, and investment in the economy. Are we consuming more? Are we saving? Are we saving less? Are we investing much? Now, the national income will help us because the components of national income, we have under the components of national income, we have the production, we have the consumption. That consumption can be governments, household, or firm. Then we have the savings. Then we have the investment, which actually is the main aspects of the firm that contributes to the production process. Now, we said the first, the uses of national income is that national income is there to look at sectorial contribution. Second, help us to look at the production structure, the level of consumption, savings, and investment in the economy. Now, also, it helps us to look at the level of economic growth in the country. Is the economy growing? At what percentage is it growing? Is it growing at 2% GDP growth rate? Is it at 3%? Is it at 6% or less than? Is the economy through the national accounts to know whether the economy is facing recession or is actually out of recession through the use of economic growth indicator? They also help us to look at the strength in the economy, to know the strength in the economy so that the investor can invest in. Before investor invest in the economy, they look at the strength of the economy, and this strength can be analyzed or assessed through using the national income accounting. The next thing is that it helps us, number five, is that national accounting helps us to look at the business functions in the economy and the level of economic policy. What are those economic policy in terms of monetary, fiscal policy in the economy? National income helps us to address such problems. Is the policy favorable? Is it effective? Is it doing well? It helps us. Then another important or uses of national income that help us to focus the future economic event. What will happen next year? What will the economy be? Where will the investment be? What will be the economic indicator that government should bring? Based on national income, we'll be able to look at what policy or favorable policy that government can engage in looking at future economic activity. Then he also used to look at the comparative, he's used to do a comparative analysis between of two or more countries. For example, we can do comparative analysis between Nigeria and Rwanda. We can do comparative between Nigeria and other European country or US. We can look at countries in their look at their performance. Is the economy growing? Why is Nigeria growing? Do we have similar economic policy? Do we have now the national income help us to look at a comparative advantage that we have discussed now? In summary, that national income is very helpful and useful in the economy, looking at those various important. Then another thing, we look at problem of measuring national income. We said that there are three main method of measuring national income last lecture. The first I told you was expenditure method. we look at, we say expenditure method, looking at what various agents, economic agents spend. We look at the income method, that means the income that is accrued to all factors of production. Then we look at what we call the output method. This is that to do with looking at all the production process and the outputs in the economy. Now, looking at it, there are challenges or problems associated with measuring national income. The first is double counting. There is a process in developing countries like Nigeria will have the challenge of double counting. That means what you have, they have what they have recorded before, they still have a tendency of recording it. They will have challenge of marketability of goods. For example, if I have a house, I'm staying in my own apartment, my own house. How will I give account on how much should I pay? But for example, if I'm on rent, I'll be able to say the rent will be 500. But if I live in my own apartment, how will I value that product? That is what we call the challenge of marketability of goods. It actually affects national income accounts. The next thing are underground economic activities, such as gambling, we also call illegal activities, such as gambling, such as prostitution, and oil bunkering and all that. This affects national income in such a way that nobody will tell you that I'm involved in oil bunkering, in gambling, or involved in prostitution in Nigeria, that prostitution is not legalized, or criminality, other activities that are not legalized in a country like Nigeria cannot be accounted for. But those activities affect the economy one way or the other, and it affects the national income. Then the next one is difficult in calculating transfer payments, such as pension, unemployment allowance, more other money, loans, soft loan giving, like for example the trader money. Now, how will you account for those money? And those money loan, they may be form of soft loan that the interest may not be paid, and they have difficulty including them in expenditure. The next one is the level of price stability in the economy, inflation. Inflation also is a problem of measure. For example, within the year, the inflation level may not be stable. Today can be high, next week can be. Now, in calculating national income in a year, and you aggregate that our price is so, is at 200 naira. Meanwhile, at the point, it was 250, at the point, it was 300. Now, this challenge of price level also affects the problem of a measurement of national income. Why the last one is the treatment of depreciation. How do we account for what we have used? For example, depreciation of cars and all that. How do we account for, how do we actually value the net worth of an asset at the end of the year? That is a problem of national income. Now, today we have discussed the uses, the problem. Now, briefly, we look at the circular flow. Under the circular flow, we'll be looking at two major: the household, which is also called the individual, and the firm, which is the business. Now, the household, for example, you have an economy like this, a two-set economy, where you have the household, which is individual, and the firm. Now, the firm is the producer of goods and services. And what they do, they do expenditure, they spend in producing. Then why the household income, the earn income, then what they do, they give out labor. They are the custodian of labor. Now, the circular flow is such that both the firm and the household have interrelationship. If the firm produces goods and services, the household will want to buy it. At the end of the day, they will spend, and the income will come to the firm. And when the firm produces, what happens? They spend, and income comes to what? To the household through labor. You see, now, in economy or national income, there's what we call the circular flow of income. That means the income moves from household to the firm, and from the firm to the household. That is what we call the process at which income move from among or between economic agents. For example, this is just a two-set economy. It moves from household to government. assuming we have three sectors, which is adding government to it, it can also move. Money can move from government to individual and individual to government in terms of tax. It can also move from firm to individual and firm to government in terms of tax. Government too can also buy, can expand buying products of goods and services from the firm. That is the national income. Lastly, today we'll be looking at national income and economic structure, so that by next week, I'll be looking at some of the calculation. We'll look at national income and economic structure, and economic structure. Here, we have about three bases. First is two-sector economy, which I've explained. Two-sector economy. Then we have three-sector. We have three-sector economy, then we have four-sector economy. Now, we'll look at them briefly before we go. Then, the two-sector, we have Y, which is the national, is equals to C plus Y, plus, C plus I. Now, the I represent the consumption of the household. The I represent the consumption of the firm. Now we have both household and the firm here. Under the, this one we call the two-sector economy. There are two-sector economy. We have the C, which is the consumption. Y is the income, now the national income. Then we'll have the C, which is the consumption. Then we'll have the I, which is the investment. That is it. Then When we move it to three-sector economy, we have G. We'll add G to it. Then we'll now have this. Now, the G included is what we call the government spending. We have the government. The government. Next class will be solving equation, how to calculate national income, solving national income, two-sector economy, three-sector. Then, for the four economy, we have YS minus import minus export. You have the what is called the foreign sector. That will give you the four sector economy. My next class will be looking at the calculation, how to calculate the national income, looking at two sector economy, three sector and four sector economy. That is it. Your take home now, class, is to actually well label or discuss the circular flow of three-sector economy. Discuss the circular flow of three-sector economy. Three-sector economy.